We had a couple of near tragedies when he was so eager to please that he ran right into a glass door. Like that.
Call My Agent was such a well-loved show. Were there any nerves at all about working on this kind of British take on the show?
Yes.
Yes, we were.
The thing about it is that John wrote the script.
Yeah, they didn't have John, you see.
They didn't have John.
And I think when we were filming it, we were so focused on kind of making what just felt like our own show that it didn't really. But I suppose now that it's about to come out, I'm a bit
more
like,
oh yeah, this has been inspired by Call My Agent.
It's not a total remake. You know, episode one starts the same and then it very much goes on its own thing.
It just immediately just felt like a John Morton show. And because this show is a slightly longer format, could get into why they're feeling how they're feeling, you know.
How hard is it when you're running through those scenes, especially this kind of meeting room scenes where you're all together and it's the dialogue is bouncing around between you all?
It's tough, yeah. It's really tough.
Like that, and he has such a specific, like, gorgeous way of writing dialogue that feels so believable, like almost like it's a documentary.
Yeah.
Like it does feel
But
it was
scripted.
Crazy. Like we had to do like line runs before.
You know, we'd always have to make sure we were sort of really on it, you know,
in
four
the makeup
or 5 hours
chair,
into,
being like, right, okay, so right, no, you say right, I'm then, and then I go, yes, but. Okay,
but that's
go,
my you know, but. I say that the
and then
second
I say but
is my
second
but.
Time
and
after
then,
that. Yeah.
So you, yeah, so you might have like four lines which go, yes, 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 no, I mean, yes. But yeah. Yes, or something. It's just a bit like this, really.
I love it, though. I think it's the closest in those meeting room scenes that I've come to doing television, doing theatre.
Oh, I agree. Absolutely, yes. It's very theatrical because his rhythms are so specific.
I have to ask about the dog. Was he well-behaved on set, and did you get on with him?
I have to ask the dog so many serious acting questions.
So many serious acting questions.
And what's your motivation for
the
scene?
And I just sort of, you know, sat quietly and observed. Mm. And just kind of, I was like, what's your process, Mark?
And it was intense.
And it was, he had some really insightful stuff to offer.
So the dog was very sweet. It was called Smurf.
Yeah, Maggie had to spend quite a lot of the shoot with her chest sort of smeared with duck pate.
Which is related to the dog. It's related to the dog.
Sorry, I died.
Yes, exactly, Lydia's.
And we had a couple of near tragedies when he was so eager to please that he ran right into a glass door. Like that. Yeah. And he actually went, and that was terrible. We all just thought, we've killed the dog.
Yeah, there was that moment. It was very early on in the process as well, of course, so the whole thing would have...
We killed the dog.
...been quite ominous from the off.
Yes.
There's an incredible list of guest stars. Was there anyone you were particularly like starstruck by?
Jack Davenport.
I was obviously such a big Harry Potter fan. So when Clemence Posey came in, I was like, Fleur de la Cour. So that was very exciting. But I think nearly all of them I was starstruck by. Like I didn't play cool even once.
No. Yeah, no, all of them.
Yeah, it's like every single
was
one.
Was not chill with any of them.
I think Helena Bonham Carter was, I suppose, a particular highlight for me. She was just magic. And
I was quite dazzled by the choice that they'd made to come and put themselves in this place of, you know, having their story as professionals and as people so just laid bare for others to just like mess about with.
It's very generous of them, you know, these very famous, brilliant actors playing essentially their kind of supporting roles, because this is a glimpse behind the curtain of the lives of the agents.
I've got Helena Bonham Carter here in the reception.
Can I just say hello to my favourite client?
Well, what happened to Jude Law die?
All the press can talk about is whether or not we're having an affair.
You can be honest with us from the outset.
Honest.
That's the very least you can expect in any kind of professional.
Welcome to Nightingale Heart. I hope you'll be very happy here.
Thank you.
This is what you look like.
Christ, it looks like the Nuremberg trials.